Hello, everyone. I'm Rick Henley. I'm the Executive Director of Acquisitions here at Rock Island Auction Company, and I want to talk to you about one of the absolutely spectacular pieces that we're going to have coming up in our September premiere sale, which is September 6th, 7th, and 8th, with a full preview on September 5th. We hope to see you there at the auction, but we're going to go through at least, like I said, one of the absolutely fantastic items we have coming up in that sale. So, first thing you'll notice about this thing is it is absolutely massive. This is a RB Rodda and Company four bore double rifle. It is, as you can see, a hammer double rifle. Rodda was a retailer in Calcutta, India. As many of you are aware, at this time period, the British Empire was at its peak. India was, they had control over India, and there was all this money flowing into India, all this royalty from Britain coming into there, and then there's also the Maharajas of India, which, so a lot of money was going to the different firearms manufacturers because of basically the safari industry at that time period there in India. So, but RB Rodda was a retailer that was set up to supply a lot of these safaris right there in Calcutta, and because of how big they were, they eventually started having their own firearms manufactured for them in England. So the majority of these were manufactured by WNC Scott, which is a very, very well-known Birmingham gun maker at the time. And based on the serial number, assuming it was manufactured by WNC Scott, we'd be looking at about 1886 that this was manufactured. So that just all makes sense that they were more likely the ones who manufactured this double rifle for Rodda. You can see right here on the table, when we talk about massive, that right there is the bullet that you'd be firing out of this. A four bore, approximately a quarter pound of lead or copper in this case. That's a more modern load that you're going to be sending down range with this double rifle. So we'll kind of get into the kind of particulars of it as well. So you can see on here, just inlaid in gold, you have RB Rodda and Company gun makers by appointment to the Viceroy of India and His Royal Highness, the Duke of Edinburgh, which were both, very big things to be able to put onto to any of your firearms that you were, manufacturers to those very important people at the time. So as well, we go into some of the engraving on here, and again, most people today kind of think of with big game safaris, you think of Africa, but like I said, this time period, really you thought of India. Africa was kind of just started to get going, but a lot of big game hunting was going on in India as well from a lot of those people that I mentioned previously. So, but when you look at this gun today, you're gonna think Africa, but it's all Indian. When you go to this side panel, you can see a game scene engraving of rhinoceros. Again, most people today are going to think of Africa with rhinoceros, but these are more than likely a Sumatran rhinoceros, which would have been somewhat plentiful at the time. Today, they're very, very rare to see. Then on the other side, we've got elephants. Again, something you think of with Africa, but these are more than likely Indian elephants, which would have been hunted at the time. And then on top, probably the most African animal you think of today, or the animal you most associate with Africa, a lion. But again, this is more than likely an Asiatic lion that they put on here, right here on the top tang. This rifle by itself, like we said, is very significant, very desirable, just because of the history behind it, the quality of how it was manufactured, obviously just the cool factor of it just being a huge four bore, something you don't see very often today. Obviously, we have much better powders. We have high velocity cartridges. You don't need to have a big four bore like this. But during the time period, it was just all about volume and weight. Volume and powder, which is why at that time period you're using a case like that, which is what you would want if you're having to stop an Indian elephant or a rhinoceros or a tiger or a lion. You want to be able to stop it, so that's why they come up with that. This gun has a, you know, absolutely fantastic history behind it, just as it sits, being a, you know, just a massive four bore, absolutely quality manufacturing in the history of India. But we talk a lot about firearms secondary history. This gun was manufactured in 1886. Almost 100 years later, it had a secondary history as this firearm, this double rifle, was owned by noted author John Ross, and he stated that this double rifle was the inspiration for the four-bore that his protagonist, Henry Bowman, used in his best-selling novel, Unintended Consequences. Many of you Second Amendment proponents might be familiar with that book. It was written at a time in the mid-90s when, just like today, there was Second Amendment was huge in debate. You know, you had the Ruby Ridge incident, the Waco incident. Obviously, we had the assault weapons ban. So at that time period, there was just a ton of talk about the Second Amendment, just like today. And so this book came out kind of at the height of that. And like I said, it's still kind of read today by Second Amendment proponents. It's a fictional work, but it goes into a lot of just the history of gun confiscation and the Second Amendment within it. So, like I said, this is essentially the four bore that would have been in the book. You know, it's hard to say that you actually had a physical object in the book, but this is what the author used as his inspiration for that book. So, again, just a very cool secondary history. Got the initial history of being just an absolutely fantastic, super rare four-bore double rifle with the great Indian theme on it. And then that secondary history because of its provenance to noted author John Ross. So, again, this is just one of the many fantastic pieces that we're going to have coming up in our September premiere sale, again on September 6th, 7th, and 8th, with a full-day preview on September 5th. Check out our website. Prior to that, the catalog will be up approximately 6 weeks ahead of the auction. And then obviously check out any of the other videos that we have on all the fantastic stuff in that auction. Again, September 6th, 7th, and 8th with a full preview on September 5th.